The scheme of the Indian Income Tax Act does not really envisage to tax transactions which are capital in nature unless there is a deemed fiction. And to begin with, capital gains is also taxed because of the deemed fiction. Insofar as transfer pricing regulations are concerned, again, the intent is to ensure that the transactions are carried on an arm's length basis. When we talk of transactions, are we looking at essentially transactions which are outside the scope of what is defined in the terms of income? Income has a definition under the Indian Income Tax Act and of course extends to facets which might be in the nature of capital, but all by itself to tax a transaction which does not have any species of income, I think that has been vindicated in the recent Bombay High Court decision of Vodafone. You are looking at taxing a transaction or an economic activity which does not have the genre of income apart from being a related party transaction. I think the Bombay High Court in its voluminous order has analyzed these aspects, and what is heartening to note is that for a decision which deals with a sophisticated aspect of tax transfer pricing, the courts have relied on the time-tested and aged principles of taxation. I think it gives a good message that you have to go back to basics to understand even these sophisticated nuances, and therefore one should not lose sight of basics. Time will tell how the revenue takes it up, whether they would escalate the matter before the highest court of the land. Considering the fact that revenue is the biggest contributory to litigation at the High Court and at the Supreme Court level, I am keeping my fingers crossed. But all in all, a good respite and a welcome judgment.